Upon launching Lightroom for the first time, you may be asked to create a new catalogue. A catalogue in Lightroom stores detail about where your photos are on your drive, information about edits you've made to your photos, and any additional data you've added to your photos, like captions, star ratings, or face recognition data. You can have multiple catalogues that deal with different sets of photos. This can be useful if you have a very large number of photos to deal with, or if you just want to create different catalogues for different types of photos. One for work and one for personal photos, for example. It's important to note that, like other applications made by Adobe, such as Premiere and Audition, that the project file, or catalogue file in this instance, does not store the images themselves. This means that if you ever move your catalogue file to a new folder or drive, it's important that you also copy your photos as well. If you are not prompted to create a new catalogue on the first launch, go to the File menu and manually select New Catalogue. This way we can properly name our catalogue and ensure we store it in a sensible place on our drive. It's a good idea to store it in the same general area as where you intend to store your photos. The Pictures folder is an obvious candidate, but technically it could be anywhere on your local computer. When you switch catalogues, the program will relaunch itself. You can toggle between three ways of displaying the interface. The first is the normal view, the second is the full screen with menu bar, and the third is full screen. This is the way I like to work, as it gives you the most screen space to view your images. You can always access the menus if you move the mouse to the top of the screen and pause for a moment. The Lightroom interface can be a little tricky to discern until we have some photos loaded into it, so let's do that first. Click on the Import button towards the bottom left of the screen to bring up the import window. Alternatively, you can choose Import from the File menu. It's important to check your settings here when you import so you don't create problems for yourself later. The import window is split into three main columns: where you're importing photos from, a preview of those photos and how you're importing them, and where your photos will be stored on your drive. In the first column, Source, find the photos that you want to import. If you've inserted a memory card into your computer, Lightroom will usually highlight that by default. If you are importing the files from somewhere else, you'll need to navigate to that folder. Once you've located your source folder, the middle column will give you a preview of all the photos available to import. Here you can tick or untick photos you do or do not want to import. You can also change the sort order and the size of the thumbnails. Capture time is usually the best sort order. Important: up the top of this window there are four options: copy as DNG, copy, move, and add. For most people, most of the time, the best option is just copy. Add will just leave the files in the original location and the Lightroom catalog will reference them there. This is a bad idea if the files are on a memory card or an external drive, as they will disappear if you disconnect the drive or remove the card. Move is a bad idea, as it means there's only one copy of your files, and if something goes wrong, then you may lose data. Copy as DNG converts files into an open, raw format. This isn't a bad idea, but I like to keep my files in their original form. Copy makes a copy of the files from the original location and puts them in a new location of your choosing to keep things neat and tidy. This is the option we will use here. This brings us to the third column. For best performance, choose Embed and Sidecar from the Build Previews drop-down menu. You can also choose to rename your files or apply develop presets or looks on import. We'll leave this off for now. The important part of this column is the destination area. Make sure you consciously choose where the files will be copied to. Again, it's a good idea to store the files in the same area as your catalog, so it's easier to move your work later on without risk of data loss. I like to organize things by date for my folder format here. When you're happy with your options, choose Import and the process will begin. Depending on how many photos you have, this could take seconds to minutes to complete. A progress bar will appear in the top left and you'll see your images start to appear as they import. Now that we have some files imported, we can better discern the interface. In the left column, we have a thumbnail of the currently selected image and the folder section, which allows you to navigate between different folders of photos that you've imported. You can also create new folders here and move files between folders if required. Right now, we just have the one folder. In the main window, we have a grid view of all our images which we can scroll through. You can adjust the size of these images using the thumbnail slider at the bottom right. To enlarge a single image to inspect it, double-click on it. In this view, clicking once will zoom in, and click again to zoom out. You can adjust how far you zoom in using the navigation window options. The default gives you a 1:1 ratio zoom. Double-click to go back to the grid view, or press G on the keyboard. At the very bottom of the screen is a film strip view that gives us little thumbnails of the images. This is useful for quickly navigating through your images while the main window is displaying one large image. To the top right of the screen, you'll see buttons to take you to the different modules within Lightroom. Generally, 99% of the time is spent between the library and develop modules. The other are more specialized that don't need to be used often or at all. In the next video, we'll look at how we can start to sort and filter our favorite images.